What? If you just won't quit, then ultimately you will get to your business goals. I hate selling. That's what everybody says. I hate selling. Like, I can't sell. Like, people normally confident and effervescent people get just like marshmallows when it's time to sell. Why do people hate selling so much? People don't hate selling. People hate rejection. People don't hate selling. They hate rejection. They hate the prospect of someone saying, I don't want you, or I don't want what you have to sell. Let's be honest about it. You don't hate selling. You hate the fact that somebody might say no, and there's nothing wrong with that. So the question isn't, how do I avoid selling? The question is, how do I get better at making my offer to the marketplace and not being so attached to whether people say yes? Well, first of all, obviously, if nobody says yes to your business proposition, you won't have a business, right? But I'm banking this on the fact that you have already identified your customers and your target market, so you know there is a market for what you're selling. Let's call that a given. Now that we've called that a given, how do you position yourself and put yourself in front of the best prospects to get a yes? That's what it's really about. So it's two different things. It's, you can't be afraid of rejection, because no is as much a part of growing a business as yes is. Your question is, how do I get more yeses and fewer no's? And the answer to that is, you have to get your offer, your business, your company in front of the best people to say yes. It's a marketing thing. You've got to figure out who your target marketer. You've got to figure out who your target audience is. And your target audience will say yes if it's the right time, the right fit, and the right offer, period. That's how you get more yeses and fewer no's.